So now, today we will be talking about job search strategies. Okay, so what is this strategy all about? Fine. So now, when somebody says like, what are you doing? So you say, I'm not doing anything these days. I'm just searching for a job, right? So this searching job itself is a job. So this is something we all should understand, that when we get a job, we put our heart and soul into it, right? Because we have to perform, because we get rewards, because we get growth, accomplishments, you know, so many things which is there. Similarly, when we are searching for the job, we should do it wholeheartedly, trying all the possible combinations so that I get a job that I am looking forward for, right? Not that any job in this world, because then again, the sense of dissatisfaction will be there. The sense of unaccomplished person will be there, right? So searching a job itself is a job. So now when there is a job, when there is a work, we have to prepare certain strategies to do that work. You agree? Yes. So now how? What should be our different strategies to search that job? Okay. Again, let's understand, guys, to those who are searching, please strategize whatever has been taught here. And those who are already working somewhere, because, you know, in the previous sessions, we have come to know that there were certain people who left their job without having anything else in hand. So let's not do all these mistakes, because job market is very, very tight these days. Okay. Few companies have just stopped hiring who used to hire in bulk. So now we have to understand that the importance of job has become very, very more. Okay. And whatever we get in hand is an experience. We should always try to grab it. Okay. Now let's move to the session for the day, which is job search strategies. So what are we going to learn today? We are going to learn how to use different job portals and networks, how to leverage LinkedIn and other professional networks, and how to research companies and job roles. Might be some of the things can be different. The PPT is not changing again?
Yes, ma'am, we are stuck in the same PPT.
What is the problem? It didn't change. It changed now, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, fine. So I have no option other than, you know, showing it in this mode only. If you have certain problem, you can just, you know, maximize the this sites. Okay. Yeah. So now the thing is, what are we going to learn today? So finding a job is very personal responsibility. Okay. So searching a job is such a job which I have to do, and only I can do it, right? Sorry. So now this is a personal responsibility. Why is it said like that? Because nobody else can do it for me. Even if people give me certain references, even if people tell me about certain opportunity, but actually cracking that interview, actually getting that offer letter is completely on my hands. Okay. So it is a personal responsibility. We each have our own techniques, process and approaches to finding work. Okay. Not necessary that if I teach you certain technique, so that is going to work on all the people attending sessions today, right? So they can be every person can have their own technique, right? So these programs are being done just to give you a generalized view, right? Like in general, this is the way. Rest, you can always use your own brains, your own techniques to get a good job. Okay? So what are you going to do today? Compare methods of seeking work, create a plan for your job search, learn strategies for accessing and contacting employers. Okay? The keys to successful job search are to know your skills and find employers who need those skill sets. So in previous classes, we have spoken about SWOT analysis, right? How many of you have done that yet? I think some of you must have attended the session. So did any of you really go back and do it? Or you have, none of you have done it? Okay, no answer so far. So now guys, please understand. If you don't change, nothing will change. If you just sit idle thinking that everything will change, nothing is going to change. If I want change, the first thing is I have to change myself. I have to change my attitude. I have to change the way I work. I understand, Shubham, that you didn't get the PPT, but I'm definitely sure you have attended the session. You know what was to be done. Because PPT doesn't contain your answer. PPT doesn't contain your strength and your weaknesses. Your opportunities and your threat, this is something you have to find. If you just lie down and listen to what is being told, it is not going to work. Unless you actually do it. So go back to the previous sessions. I have asked all of you to do a SWOT analysis. Do a SWOT analysis and then you will find out what are the key things because of which you are not able to get the kind of job that you demand for yourself. You will get to know what are the kind of opportunities are lying there in the market and what is threatening you to grab it. Right? So first key is knowing your own skill sets. And second important is those employers who need these kind of skill sets. We'll also discuss several strategies for keeping up with labor market trends, targeting employers, developing a solid career plan, and much more. But again, before I move ahead, I would really want to say, guys, if you don't follow what is being told, if you just feel like hearing from this ear and sending it out from this ear, this attitude is not going to bring any change in our life. Just attending lecture will not help. You have to work on those lectures. Okay? Fine. So what is section one says? Before you begin, know what you want. So let's first understand what is that I am looking for myself. If a department, you know, have several sectors, faces, factors, industries, products, services. So now it is, I have to decide which area, which thing that I want to get into. So sit back, think, make an analysis. If you don't know what kind of work you want to do, including specific occupational titles, fields, conducting a job search can be just exhausting and frustrating. Because when you are running after one job, you will find that this particular aspect of the job is not something that I was looking for. You will leave and run after some other job. So this strategy is not going to work. And this is just going to be very annoying and frustrating for you. Because when results doesn't come out quickly, we tend to get frustrated. Right? So first, it is important to know what kind of work are you looking at? क्या चाहिए आपको लाइफ से? Planning and organizing your job search. Ready, set, go. Start your job search with focus, understanding changing labor market. Locating and interpreting job listings and online job search strategies. ठीक है, चलिए एक एक करके हर एक के बारे में समझते हैं. Planning and organizing your job search. ठीक है, so definitely, जैसे मैंने कहा, job search करना भी अपने आप में एक job है. I can give you an example. You know, I was just conducting a session for a few experienced guys. You know, it was a first session which I conducted personally. So now, one of the candidate in that session gave me his experience that he was working in an IT field. It was a company called SunGard, where he got his first placement. But after 4 years, he had to leave that company due to some personal reason. And he could not be into the market for next 2 years. Okay. After 2 years, when he went back to search jobs, now his skills were all outdated. IT companies adapt itself so fast with the changing things around it that all those stuff became obsolete for him, whatever skills he had. So now he didn't want to get back to his older package because definitely experience do matter for him and he was looking for something good. So what did he do? So he told me, ma'am, what did I do? I applied for more than 40 jobs, which was similar or somewhat similar to my skills and my profile. I went to more than 20 interviews. And I went to those interviews to fail. Every interview that I went, I listed down all the questions which was asked from me. I collated all of them. And I prepared answers to all these questions. And once when I was done with it, I went to the next company. And it was Accenture for him. And he could get through easily. He told me, ma'am, the truth is there were many skills which I never knew. In these 2 years, many new softwares were into the market and I was not aware. But I strategized my plan of searching a job for myself. And then he got through. Even today he mails me, even today he is in touch. It's almost 4 or 5 years now since he restarted. So that is how we all have to strategize, plan things. Job search strategies can vary widely in effectiveness, broaden your ability to look for work in several different career paths, not just one path. Organize your time in a calendar or planner. Keep an up-to-date journal that documents the efforts and progress of your job search. Now, when I go, I am a consultant. I have told several times I'm HR consultant. I'm associated with few companies in the market and I do recruitments for them. So when I go to the, campus placements, one thing that I have found that if the season has ended. And if somebody did not or could not be placed somewhere, they stop reading. They stop preparing and they just keep waiting. Just sit back and wait that the opportunity is going to come to them. This doesn't happen. Aisa nahi hota hai. Opportunities will never come to you. You have to go to the opportunity. So you have to keep yourself prepared. Keep a journal, keep a diary with yourself. Note down your everyday activity. What have you done? Which action of yours or which activity of yours is going to create a difference in your life tomorrow? Which activity is going to bring you more closer to your dream job, to your work that you really wanted to have. Oh. So the first important thing, the first important point is plan and organize. And in that planning, a journal, a diary comes into picture. Okay. What all other information is required to keep your job search organized? What are the, or which are the places where I have submitted the applications? Now, what do? We go on Naukri, we go on Indeed or any of the other job portal, and we just find out this job, click, apply, click, apply, click, apply. We don't even bother to see what are the detailed job description that has been mentioned. What is the location that is mentioned? What is the industry? What is the sector? We just want a job. So we just keep clicking on the application button, apply, apply, apply. And what happens? I don't keep a track of which are the companies where I have applied. And so I never do this calling to them. I never follow up that I have applied in your company. And what happens? It just goes into the garbage box. So the first, so second important suggestion here is, wherever you apply, note it down somewhere. You want to prepare an Excel about it, prepare an Excel. Name of the company which you have applied, the position you have applied, date you have applied. So that accordingly, after a few days, you can give back a call to the employer, maybe on their landline or anywhere, wherever, whichever number you get from internet, and ask, is this position still open or it is closed? So first important thing is submitted application. So wherever you have given your applications, wherever you have applied, keep a note, keep a track of it. Okay. Network contact updates and maintenance. Network. Now, networking is very important. We have already spoken about it. So, jo bhi aapke networks mein hai, keep that contacts updated with you. Some of my contact, some of my network might have changed the companies. Some of my network might have changed their status. So, keep that, you know, whatever changes has been made, you always receive a notification regarding that. See, now everything doesn't need to be, you know, mentioned in the journal or the Excel. Something just needs to be kept here. But unless I have that focused mindset, I won't be able to do it. Okay. Target jobs and companies. You have to search out those specific jobs and specific companies where you are really looking forward for getting placed. Search their websites. Find out from different job portals. Have they posted any jobs similar to your skills? Check their websites. Sometimes if you can get, connected on LinkedIn, get connected to them on LinkedIn and start talking to these senior people. You know, they would love to help you out. So make a list of the companies where you want to go and the jobs which you have found it posted somewhere. It can be newspaper, it can be internet, social media, anywhere. Meetings and scheduled interviews. Again, note it down. All the interviews which has been scheduled as per the along with the dates. And if in some companies interviews could not be scheduled, call and find out. So this calling is follow-up task. See, understand. I don't mean that everybody you call is going to entertain you. Because there are hundreds of candidates. And every candidate, if they start calling the HR or calling the concerned person, of course, they're not going to reply. But which of my luck will click where, we never know. So rather than just sitting and thinking ki bhai itne log kya call karenge aur wo jawab denge, it is better you make a call. You never know It was only you who they were waiting for. Weekly accomplishments. Make a journal. Review your journal, review your diary weekly. Kitne companies mein apply kiya tha? Which all companies did I apply? From where did I get the reply? Which companies didn't send me reply? What was the job description which was mentioned? How much my skill sets matches to that JD? How much I need to improve? Lock career websites that you see or use frequently. Fine. So this is a chart which has been prepared for you. This is to start your job search with focus. Okay. If you don't want to keep a diary, if you don't want to keep a journal, just prepare this chart somewhere and answer the questions. Trust me, you're going to answer this to yourself, nobody else. कोई आपका डायरी नहीं चेक कर रहा है, कोई आपके होमवर्क्स नहीं चेक कर, दिस इज नॉट एन होमवर्क और एन असाइनमेंट, इट इज जस्ट अ टास्क व्हिच नीड्स कंप्लीशन एंड फॉर यू ओनली. ओके, इट्स ऑल इटसेल्फ, इट इज अंडरस्टैंडेबल. स्टिल आई विल जस्ट रीड इट आउट फॉर यू. सो रिकॉर्ड अ प्रोफेशनल ग्रीटिंग ऑन योर वॉइस मेल. ओके, सो रिकॉर्ड, दिस मीन्स दैट रिकॉर्ड अ kind of introduction, a small introduction, not the big one. Okay, a small introduction in your mobile or anywhere where you can record yourself. Okay, create a professional email address and email signature. So I am sure you all must be having a professional email address. Why it is a professional? Because many a times we see that, you know, the email address contains words like cute, sweet, and for you, numbers are there and all those things. So, you know, professional email address should not contain all these things. You put your nicknames there, so it shouldn't be there. A professional email address should have your complete name, your name and your title. Okay, and if some numbers are required, you can put some numbers, some underscores, some dots, whatever, you know, the email address is available, you can see. But don't put any adjective on that. Okay, so you must be having an email address and email signature. If you can create somewhere, do that. Write a targeted career commercial that tells an employer or a contact exactly what you can do for the employer, not what the employer can do for you. So again, we are going back to the thing that we have already studied in the resume building, which speaks about my profile summary. तो दो लाइन की प्रोफाइल समरी बनाएंगे हम. ठीक है, एमबीए ग्रेजुएट विथ 5 years ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस इनटू स्विच, एमबीए ग्रेजुएट विथ 5 years ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस इनटू मार्केटिंग, वट एवर इट इज, अ बीबीए ग्रेजुएट विथ 2 years ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस इनटू maybe anything of finance, HR, whatsoever. So this is something which tells the employer immediately. Dilip, you wants to ask some question? Okay. So a small summary which tells your employer immediately, right? Just in one or two lines, that why are you an important candidate for them? So you have to mention this, write it down somewhere. So complete this in this task only. Build your networking contact list, your professional list, personal list and your acquaintances. Ek list prepare kijiye. Professionally, who can help you? Personally, who can help you? And then it is acquaintance. You know, what is an acquaintance? Some people whom we don't know directly, but through somebody. Or some people who are not very close, but I know him. Maybe an old neighbor, you know, my brother's boss, my sister's somebody, kind of. So that is an acquaintance. Somehow related to me, connected to me. राइट. सो एक लिस्ट बनाइए, एक लिस्ट प्रिपेयर कीजिए ऑफ ऑल दोस गाइस हु कैन हेल्प यू. गिव देम अ कॉल, गेट देम कनेक्टेड ऑन लिंक्डइन, गिव देम अ कॉल एंड आस्क. देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम इन आस्किंग इफ दे कैन हेल्प यू विद अ जॉब. Prepare that list, because sometimes we tend to forget most important people of our life who could have really helped us, but we don't remember. Yeah, list your accomplishments, list what you have done for previous employers to enhance their business profits, processes and more. So this is a normal resume, also this content. Or a maybe normal interview content, like what has been your achievements. List down your achievements somewhere. Okay? So why this listing is required separately? Because sometimes when you really go for the interview, we tend to forget that this work is also was done by me. This was also my achievement. And when we come out of the interview room, we start recollecting them. I forgot to say this. Oh, this was just missed out. So it shouldn't happen like that. If you make a list and before entering that interview room, if you just go through that list, then everything will be recalled. But it has to be written somewhere, right? Research, gain understanding of your local labor market. So what is labor market? This workforce that we are talking about, right? Hamare aas paas jo companies hai, uspe kis type ke workforce kaam karte hai. So that also plays an important role in the process of searching a job. Okay. So now if I am in a place like maybe Pune, or I'm in a place like Hyderabad or Bangalore, and in these places, if I look for more manufacturing jobs than IT jobs or, you know, any similar domains, so I'll be, you know, finding it difficult because these places are known more for its IT related things, right? So we have to understand what is the local workforce market, what is the local labor market, you know, where it is not something ki un cities mein dusre jobs available hi nahi hai. Hey, of course hai, but not in abundance, but not in good numbers. Okay, so understand your local labor market. Okay, and even if these market have some jobs for you, so you have to find out which are those people who are hiring people like you. Create, organize, update your professional portfolio of work. Include evaluation, certifications, licenses, degrees. So again, this is talking about the same thing that we have done during resume building. Jitne bhi certifications hai aapke, jitne bhi degrees hai, sabko ek jagah accumulate karke rakh dijiye. So is task mein kya karenge? Is task mein hum log mention karenge. Yes, all my degrees, all my certificates, jitne bhi hai, ye hai. And this is what I have collated and kept it somewhere. Okay? Find one or more job fairs that you can attend to expand your networking contacts. Every city, you know, people like mostly political parties or, you know, sometimes industry biggies, they organize some or the other kind of job fair. The screen case cannot be seen now. What happened? There is some change on the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, madam.
Yes,
ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Why is somebody doing it deliberately? Okay, just a second. Okay, is it seen now?
Yes, yes. It is visible. Okay,
great. Fine. So now try and go and attending those job fairs. If you cannot land up in a good job through those job fairs, at least you will be able to network with some good industry people. Okay, you can create your impression. So now, which are the job fairs which is happening in and around me? You have to do an extensive search about it. You can get it through some social media platforms. You can get to know about it through some newspapers or maybe, you know, some similar job hunting groups kind of things. Okay. So, we have to be ready with it, right? Agar hum ye regularly nahi karenge, so it will just happen as if it passed yesterday and I was not aware, I could not go. So we have to keep all these things handy, ready. All this information should be there in the mind all the time so that I can work accordingly. Okay? So now again, I will say, whoever is attending the session, please complete this task for yourself, not for anybody else. Understanding the changing labor market. Okay? Labor market research simply means getting a picture of the economy and the workplace. Hamari economy kis taraf ja rahi hai? What is new in our country? So previously we used to say that we are mostly dependent on the agriculture sector. But today the market scenario has changed. India is also known for its manufacturing. India is also known for its IT sector. India is also known, previously India was only known in the Western countries for its cheap labor. But now things have changed. Even India doesn't have cheap labor market. You know, everybody charges good for their services, just in case the service has to be good too. So these are the pictures which is changing around you. Are you aware? Every year a budget is being presented in our country. Okay. So what happens after budget? Do you really go back and find out what this budget really means? Which are the areas this budget is supporting? Which are the areas this budget is just not supporting? If you go and review, you will understand all these things. What are the changing dynamics of the workplaces today? How things are evolving?
Mom, you are on mute.
Mommy,
you are not audible.
Okay, am I audible now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm so sorry. Fine.
Mom, so this, actually, I want to ask a question, if you don't mind in between.
Okay, tell me.
Mom, you just said in the previous slide that you need to write only two sentence summary, like an MBA with a 5 years of experience. Is it sufficient to write in a CV or resume having the experience of 5 to 6 years?
Not every job requires experience of 5 to 6 years. That is why we hire freshers. There are several openings that is only meant for somebody who has, you know, initial experience of 1 or 2 years.
What I'm trying to ask is, if somebody is having an experience of 5 to 8 years, so is it okay to write only two sentence, or it can be elaborated to 5 to 6?
No. See, what am I telling you here? Ye jo task description hai, this is not meant for your resume. Resume needs to have a good profile summary of one paragraph, maybe 5 lines or 6 lines. Okay, that gives a complete picture about your professional experience. Okay, but here we are talking about a small task which you should be ready all the time. Write a targeted career commercial that tells an employer exactly what to do for the employer. What you can do, not what employer can do for you. So now, this is a small two-liner. And you have to write it for yourself so that it brings confidence into you that, yes, I can do it. Okay, so this is a task which you have to complete, not for the employer, but for yourself. This will give you a sense of understanding about yourself. Did you get that? So here we are not talking about profile summary of resume. Here we are talking about a profile summary which I should understand about myself.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. So now here we were talking about understanding the labor market. Okay. So since I was on mute, so I was just talking that understand the labor market which is around you. Okay. So previously our country was dependent on mostly on the agro products, agriculture. But now India is also known for its manufacturing. India is also known for its IT related things. And India is also known, for many other equipments, many other, different automobiles, different mobiles, and then so many products, right? So this shows that the dynamics have changed. So you should go around and see, like if you stay in a particular city, in a particular state, so what the state is promoting the most, what the city is promoting the most, which is the main economical hub for this place where I am. And then you will get a picture, the kind of workforce and the kind of workplace this area, this region, this location has. Who are the best businesses and hiring organizations to target in that region? Wherever you are, in whichever region you are residing, find out the best businesses. It doesn't mean the big only. It can be small businesses also. If you are in a place like Mumbai, if you are in a place like Bangalore, even Delhi, or any big city, you will find out that these cities are actually blooming with lots of startups today. And startups need young people, young blood. So you understand, who is hiring in that location, which is the best business today in that location. So do a research. Labor market resources can provide information about occupations that are in demand. Kya kya kaam hai demand mein currently? Or decline, current wages, short-term and long-term projections. So for this reason, I said that every year in our country, budget is being presented. Go back and look at the review. Just do a small review of the budget. Which are the sectors which this budget has supported? Which are the sectors which this budget is not supporting? So जो उसमें सपोर्ट उसको ज्यादा मिल रहा है प्रोबेबली उसी एरिया में जॉब भी ज्यादा होगा. सो फॉर दिस टू डू अ कंप्लीट रिव्यू यू हैव टू गो बैक एंड रीड इट एंड वंस यू रीड यू विल अंडरस्टैंड द चेंजिंग डायनेमिक्स ऑफ द लेबर मार्केट. ओके. लोकेटिंग एंड इंटरप्रीटिंग जॉब लिस्टिंग्स. ठीक है. Job listings can contain confusing language. Understanding what it, understanding what the employer really is looking for in a good candidate can be challenging. Okay. So kabhi kabhi JD jo job descriptions mentioned hote hai, roles and responsibilities mentioned hote hai, wo bahut clear nahi hote. Theek hai. Try to read it several times. And if you're still not clear, I would suggest to take help from some mentor or some guide. Okay, who can you help you understand what is being mentioned there? Okay, your task is to figure out the specific knowledge, skills, experience the employer requires that will lead you to an interview. An ideal job listing will clearly state what the employer needs. Okay, so a good employer will always try to give very clear roles and responsibilities so it doesn't create confusion. But it doesn't every time happen like that. Kabhi kabhi log aise roles dalte hain jo hame khud samajh nahi aata. Theek hai. Probably I can be the suitable person for that, but I am not able to understand. So to decipher that, to understand that, it is better to connect with somebody and understand what this job role really means. Many times the requirements will be listed in order of importance with the most crucial qualification first. Okay. Online job search strategies. Now, job search, we don't do job search through newspapers. I think most of us have stopped doing that. We don't get job requirements on our mobile phone in form of messages or WhatsApp, right? So how do we do these job search? We go to various social media platforms. We go to various internet portals. And from there, we do these job search. But there is a several, just hold for a second, guys. Huh? So how to use these internet resources, okay? Social media, job boards, news outlets, subject-specific blogs, trade-specific magazines, company websites, job search support websites, and much, much more, okay? How to use this? Job search strategies in today's labor market rely on using the internet. How extensively you use internet and how do you use it? It is very important. I use Facebook, right? I use Instagram. I use Twitter. And similarly, I use YouTube and several other platforms. How? But how? Can you, Priyanka, just mute? Somebody has just unmuted them.
Ma'am, could you please recap 8th number slide? I mean, just show it once.
This is 8th. Tell me. You want to ask something?
Right, clear now.
Okay.
Ma'am, I have a small query.
Yeah, please.
Ma'am, at the time of COVID, we know that every company has given work from home opportunities. But after COVID, okay, now companies have changed their strategies and they are not providing any work from home opportunities. They are providing hybrid model, like 2 days work from office, three days work from home. So on LinkedIn and Naukri, when we search for jobs, we are getting that part-time work from home opportunities. But if we approach them now, they are just MLM companies. So how can we know that the companies are genuine?
No, I didn't understand it. Like, you want to understand whether this company and its posting is genuine or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. So genuine in terms... Yeah, tell me.
Actually, whenever we see any job postings, most of them are preferring work from home jobs nowadays also. But we all know that the companies have stopped the work from home opportunities and they are calling the employees to work from office. So whenever we see an opening or anything on LinkedIn or Naukri or any other job portal, like part-time work from home, when we approach them, they are just MLM companies.
Correct.
So how to avoid this such things, and how can we know that this is the genuine company which provides work from home opportunities? There are still some companies which provide work from home opportunities, but how should we identify them?
Okay, fine. So my first question is, what's your name?
Ma'am, Pranav.
Pranav. So Pranav, the first question is, why are you looking for a work from home opportunity?
As nowadays we are getting a hybrid model, I have attended some interviews. So
please understand few things first. Okay. If it is a work from home opportunity which you are getting posted on different social networks or social media sites, and if it is not posted, from a reliable or a trustworthy company, then maximum chances are there that this is going to be fake. Okay. Second important thing, why this generation is believing more in working from home. When you work from home, you don't get things to learn. You don't know how to coordinate with people. You don't know how to deal with different kind of people, different challenges. You don't, you're not able to develop your personality accordingly. So why are you even looking for a work from home opportunity? See, I understand for few, it may be a majboori kind of thing, that I have no other option other than working from home because some of my family member is not well and I have to look after that. I am a mother of a small child or something like that. So agar aisi opportunities or aisi buri halat nahi hai life mein, so why are you looking for a work from home opportunity? And even the things which you're calling that these companies ask you to do MLM kind of thing, so let's understand, are you really interested in doing that? You're not. Why are you running after these opportunities then? See, this is what we are here talking about. Social media. We have to use this social media very, very responsibly. It just can't be a prey of this. Hum bewakoof nahi ban sakte hain because of this social media. You know, few days back, it's not few days, few years back, I would say maybe 3-4 years or 2-3 years back, many people lost their money from their account just because of one small greed. Free. This amount may be credited to your account for free, interest free. So why this greed is there? Why easy money? Why do we have that kind of mindset? This is not going to help. Every job requires your hardship, struggles, challenges, and this is something which teaches you to become stronger, to become much, much experienced, to get growth in life. Don't run after these work from home opportunities. This is not going to help you. Yeah.
Ma'am, actually, I work in a skill set industry like hospitality. After the COVID, I observed that the persons who are new is not adaptable to this industry because like, they were working from home from the system, so they are not adaptable at all. And they are trying to be in their comfort zone. They are not trying to be out of their comfort zone because hospitality industry is not an easy industry. So I guess working from home has a disadvantage, not any
of. Of course, that is what I want to say. Working from home has a disadvantage unless there is something which is bothering you in your life. Might be there is some even more, you know, responsibility is there, which is, you know, bigger than your work, but you still need money. So you can, you know, opt for such things. But otherwise, never opt for this work from home opportunities. At work, at home, we are always distracted by number of things. We are never focused. So our productivity goes down. So, you know, in the race of growth, in the race of appraisals, in the race of increment, I will be considered low. Okay. So to all of you who is running after this work from home thing, stop doing it. This is not going to help.
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah.
Another ma'am. I was listening to this conversation. One guy just given the example of the hospitality. Okay, there is another industries also, like IT industries, software industries. Okay, even you are going to the homes. Why I am saying this? Like work from home is having the disadvantage also, but it is having the advantage also. It is having, it can impact the social benefit also, like IT sector and the software sector. You are going to the office and you're simply sitting to the desktop or laptop only. Okay. So even you can work from home in that scenario also. If you are doing the work from home in that scenario, you are not increasing the traffic on the road. As you know, we are the populated country now. Okay. So in the metro city, we always, when we are going to the office, when we are coming from the office, we are struggling hard to reaching the office and to coming back to the home.
Yeah. Okay. So that is
sorry to there interrupt. Are some different industries also. Which
sorry to interrupt.
Guys, please listen.
Yes.
We are getting diverted from the topic we are discussing.
We are not debating here whether work from home is good or bad. Okay. Work from home has its advantages and disadvantages. Yes. But yes. What here we are talking about, that work complete work from home.
Yes, when it is necessary, like you are having some meeting with the client, and because office existence is
I think
required.
We are getting diverted from the topic.
All of you be quiet, and I'll pick it from here. Just now you have said meeting with the client, right? So meeting with the client has come after 3, 4, 5, 6 months or 1 year. I was completely working from home. So I forgot the normal gestures, how I was supposed to talk to the client. This happens when we are completely working from home. I understand the traffic on the road. But what about my personal growth? Where do I learn from? Just this laptop is going to help me everything? Who is going to teach me how to coordinate? Who's going to teach me? So it is not about, so we are not here debating on work from home and work from office. Definitely, everything has advantages and disadvantages. But here, if you ask me, I will always suggest either it should be work from office or it should be a hybrid model. You can create traffic on road. We all understand this traffic is very bad these days. But does this excuse help you during appraisals? This traffic was bad and I couldn't come to the office, so I choose to sit at home and work. Will you be ready to take lesser pay increment? Because the company will say you didn't travel. So you saved your health. You saved the cost of traveling. You saved so much of your time. So let's take less pay. So will you accept that? You will not. You will come back fighting that I have worked so hard.
It is not
so
about
please understand everything has its pros and cons. Okay.
Yes.
It's
yes,
both
that's
ways. Yes.
We cannot completely deny it and we cannot completely accept it. Right?
Exactly.
Like we are learning. We are learning in front of you being at home. We are not
exactly.
Coming to your class, right? But we are learning. Perfectly, we are learning. So in every industry,
okay.
We are having different hierarchy.
Now you are learning. That is true. But 70 of people who are attending this classes, how many of you are interacting? If this would have been a physical class, this would have been more interactive. But if we are all learning here, we have all the cameras off. None of the camera is on. So I don't know how many are learning. We as a lecturer is putting up so much of effort. We as a trainer is putting in so much of effort. How much am I able to really change people? So end result is important. Efforts will not help. So if after these 8 sessions, if I come to know that some of you have changed, some of you have been able to use the learnings from this session into the real workplace, then this effort will be paid off, guys. I understand few of you are very good, follow everything, but not everyone. Okay? And here we were not debating on work from home or work from office. The question that was raised by 2 people was, that we get these opportunities on internet, but actually this doesn't exist. So I was just trying to explain, don't run after them, don't run after work from home opportunities, rather than go for the real opportunities where your experiences will be even higher. Okay?
Fine. Ma'am, I have another question. What should be the frequency on follow-ups on our job applications? I mean, sometimes it does feel for the recruiters ki we have lack of patience. So, I mean, how can we professionally handle it, the follow-ups?
Yeah. So the follow-up should not be done very quickly. The follow-up should be done at least in an interval of 5 to 6 days and not before that. If somehow you have been able to get the direct number of the concerned person, refrain from calling them, rather than give them emails. Okay? So emails doesn't annoy people. Calls annoys. Okay? So there should be a gap in following up. Follow-up doesn't mean ki aap piche pad jaiye kisi ke, but follow-up means to just check out if the process is still going on, if I am shortlisted or not, what all key skills are required. Maybe if I applied to Naukri, I could not get shortlisted. So the same job is available on the website also. So I will once again go through my resume. I will change the key skill sets which was required and I will apply again. And then I'll follow up. So follow up has to be done whether job still persists. Follow up has to be done whether I am shortlisted or not. And then stop following up. Got that?
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. Fine. So now, just small things here. The tool we are talking about here is Facebook. Okay. So what is a Facebook? Now, what is a Facebook? Here, I don't want to explain what is a Facebook. Everybody knows. But in just in terms of professional platform, how this Facebook can be used. So what is Facebook in professional terms? Okay. Interactive website that allows you to connect with friends, family, businesses, networking contacts, common interest user groups. It allows you to post status, updates concerning what is happening in your life, world of work, or other events. When you post, right? On any of the social media profile, which is publicly open to for everyone to see, be seen, please be careful while posting, while commenting, and while liking anything. Because that resonates your personality. If it has been noticed that you have been, you know, liking lots of political drama, if you have been liking something related to religion, maybe you never thought before liking it, right? You just did it for the sake of tick marks. You just did it for the sake of making somebody happy, right? But this, people start referring it to your personality. Okay? So on social media, we are all open to everyone. And today people knows me through the social media only. So when you post updates, you know, also, now again, this social media is definitely a boon, but can be cursed too. If you have been found that you post very frequently, I have been to this place, I have been to that place, I enjoyed night there, I enjoyed day there. We had a reunion, we had a party, we had a family day out and all those things. If an employer finds you through Facebook and see so many updates like this, so they feel ye banda kaam karne wala nahi hai, ye time pass hai. And on the basis of that, they may reject your candidature. So before you post, you have to be very, very careful. Okay? Like, what does a Facebook do again? It allows you to like businesses, organizations, or other entities so you can view their status updates, watch for job listings, other valuable updates that increase your knowledge of their operations. Okay? So Facebook में बहुत सारे businesses हैं, बहुत लोगों ने अपने businesses के या probably कुछ groups बना रखे हैं. So you can actually go and like them, comment on their products, comment on the services that they are providing. Okay, so all these things can get you more closer to the employer. You understand them and they understand you through your these small gestures. Facebook also allows you to attend events posted by companies or friends, such as job fairs, application sessions, right? So बहुत सारे लोग भी Facebook पे अपने webinars post करते हैं, या फिर कुछ ऐसे अफेयर्स पोस्ट करते हैं, जॉब्स पोस्ट करते हैं. आप उन्हें देख सकते हो. यू कैन यू नो सी दीज थिंग्स, यू कैन अप्लाई थ्रू देम, एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो अटेंड दीज सेमिनार्स और वेबिनार्स, बिकॉज दीज सॉरी वेबिनार्स बिकॉज दीज आर जनरली फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट. वेन दे सेंड लिंक ऑफ देयर वेबिनार्स ऑन प्लेटफॉर्म्स लाइक फेसबुक एंड इंस्टाग्राम स्पेसिफिकली, दैट मीन्स it is mostly free of cost. So since it is free, we all can attend, right? Join or create non-public groups, focus on your occupation, alumni association, and much more things you can do on Facebook. So rather than wasting your valuable time on Facebook, try to utilize your time there. Okay? Now what are the do's on Facebook? Karna kya chahiye hame? If you are concerned about your privacy, set account settings to custom level so that individuals, groups that you don't want to view your daily activities see only your basic profile information. Most of the time, our settings are open to all. Public view. So again, what happens when employer is searching you and searches you on that Facebook, so आपके जितने भी फालतू के postings होंगे उस पर वो अपना एक story बना डालेगा. They'll create a perception about you. So rather than doing this, it is better that if you just want to know your personal profile to them, like where you have studied from, where you have worked previously, where you are working currently, you just let them open to see only your basic information. Okay? Only your close contacts, only those people who are added into your network can see rest of your status, rest of your updates. Okay? Use applications like BranchOut to post your resume to the site and to network with others through friend contacts and that are in common. Okay? So sometimes some of your friends or acquaintances contact have some important person's connection. So through Facebook, you can yourself also get added to these guys. And also, if their information is available, you can send your resumes directly to them, giving a reference of your friend or acquaintance. Okay? Look at businesses, friends. These could be organizations they partner with, subsidiaries, employees, and human resource staffs. The business has posted something, right? So that business is available on Facebook. So when that business is available, many of its close, like maybe the employees who are working there, or those clients or customers who are, you know, using or maybe endorsing the product or services of that particular business, are all associated. So you can go and check out their profiles as well. Okay? These could be organizations that they partner with, the subsidiaries, employees. So, you know, you get a chance to get more connected. This, all these things can happen if you're actually following one company to get a job there, or maybe two or three companies to get a job there. if my focus area is maybe three companies, I have just thought about myself, I want to get into telecom, so now I want to get into Idea, Vodafone or Reliance. Okay, so if I am following only these three companies, then this type of strategy is going to help me in my job search. Okay, so I have to be focused here. Emphasize the education and work section of your personal info. Employers will want to learn that what you have studied and where you have worked. So generally, why this is mentioned, we definitely do all these things on LinkedIn, but on Facebook, we generally, you know, just don't care. Like about mentioning about our education, about mentioning about, you know, the places where I have worked before, or, you know, the skills that was used and all. So it is now suggested that try using Facebook equally important as other social media platforms when in the time is that you are searching for a job. जब आप जॉब सर्च कर रहे हैं तो फेसबुक को भी किसी भी दूसरे सोशल मीडिया प्लेटफॉर्म की तरह ही यूज कीजिए, जैसे आप जॉब सर्च के लिए करने के लिए उनको यूज करते हैं. ओके, सो दिस स्ट्रैटेजी इज गोइंग टू हेल्प यू. नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एंड द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस वर्किंग प्रोफेशनल्स इज लिंक्डइन. व्हाट इज लिंक्डइन? An interactive website used for professional and job search networking. You can request and build connections with other professionals, previous employers, former co-workers, customers, and others to increase the size and power of your job search networking circles. So this is what LinkedIn allows you to do. Network with n number of people. Network with your focused group of people. Network who's going to help you and maybe get you the job that you have been waiting for. Okay, so do extensive networking, guys. Jitna kar sakte ho. What are the other features of LinkedIn? Recommendations from those with whom you have worked. So now asking for recommendation is a no problem at all. Even if some of you likes my lectures, you can go to my LinkedIn profile and give me a recommendation. I will also love it. So similarly, you can also ask for recommendations from the people who are known to you mostly professionally, not from those who are personally associated to you. Okay, direct connections, people you know can introduce you to their connections. So what happens on LinkedIn? When I am connected to somebody, then his all connections start showing me as people you might be interested in. Some of those connections can be of my interest too. Okay, what are the things LinkedIn do? Employers list jobs through posts. So lots of postings happens on LinkedIn. The way you have just mentioned that you find lots of false postings on this social media, like work from home opportunities and all MLM kind of things. Similarly, even LinkedIn also sometimes have certain posts which people just do for the sake of posting, but not really hiring from it. Okay. But now as a job searcher, right, since I am in this, this is what my job is currently, to search a job. So I would suggest, like, apply for all the jobs that is available on LinkedIn, that is posted on LinkedIn, so that whichever has to click will just click. We just can't sit back and think this might be a false posting, or they might not hire me. Okay, so better than this, it is better to keep applying. What are do's on LinkedIn? Yes,
agree that you can apply on every job which is posted on LinkedIn,
But in a 10 job postings, there is a one job posting which will be of MLM company. That is on LinkedIn.
Okay.
And which looks like that the professionals are hiring for us.
Okay.
As the use of AI is going, as we are using AI nowadays, everyone is using AI to do a post on LinkedIn. So how can we identify that it is not an MLM company?
See, Pranav, now everywhere we have to use our brain. Okay, that is very important. Now, to identify something which is not mentioned there is like reading between the lines. So you have to use your analyzing power to identify what is really this job description that is looking like. I have just spoken in my previous slide that sometimes job listings confuse us. Exactly what is roles and responsibility? We just don't understand, right? In those scenario, it is better to either take a guidance from somebody who is experienced or try to read what is being mentioned between the lines. Aakhir ye kehna kya chahta hai? If you analyze, you will get to know how real or how fake this posting is. Okay? And it is always suggested, don't give your prominent informations like your email IDs, your contact numbers on the social media platforms. You can apply, and maximum what you can do is you can just, you know, get ask them to get connected to you through LinkedIn only. If they like your application, probably they can send you a message, and then you can know how real or how fake it is. Okay? You got my point, Pranav?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So what are the do's on LinkedIn? Let's understand.
I don't get it.
No.
I don't get it, ma'am.
Learn about their companies and line of work and ask for their feedback on your LinkedIn profile to see how you can draw views from potential employers. Okay, so those whom you think is a good guide for you or a good mentor for you, you can always ask them, you know, how you can better your profile, how you can make it more noticeable by the employer, what all needs to be added, what all needs to be changed, right? Update your information frequently. So some or the other updates needs to be done on LinkedIn so that, you know, your profile is always on the top of the searches. If you have learned newer versions of software, remove the outdated versions. आपने कुछ नया सीखा है, जिसका upgraded version सीखा है, तो बुरे पुराने versions को remove कीजिए and add that new certification, new version, whatever you have learned. Okay? One important thing. If you are searching for a job and if you are not working anywhere, if you are working, don't do this. This, you know, this will alert your current employer. But if you are not working, that green ring, you know, on LinkedIn, open to work, apply that ring on your profile picture. Okay? Check your profile completeness. Now, LinkedIn gives you a percentage in terms of completeness, 50% completed, 60% completed, 80% completed. And it also tells you which are the areas which is still to be completed. Check that completeness chart. And then whatever information you have not mentioned, go back and mention it. Okay? Your complete profile will help you get more closer to the potential employer. That will help you get closer to the companies, to the people you want to get connected to. Okay? So now you are understanding the searching this job is itself is a job. And you have to strategize. You have to plan in order to get what you are willing for yourself. Okay? There are certain things which LinkedIn can't do itself. LinkedIn खुद से नहीं कर सकता है. We have to go and do it. Employer cannot search your profile and send you direct recruiting emails when you are a match for the positions. Even if you are the best match, employer cannot come and search you directly. It may happen sometimes, but most of the time it doesn't happen. Why it doesn't happen, I'll tell you. Now, LinkedIn shows me those profiles which are either directly connected to me or if connected to some of my connected acquaintance. Okay? Agar ye banda दूर दूर तक मेरे कनेक्शन में नहीं है, सो दोज प्रोफाइल्स विल नेवर कम बिफोर अस. सो एम्प्लॉयर कैन नॉट कम सर्चिंग फॉर यू, यू हैव टू गो सर्चिंग फॉर द एम्प्लॉयर. लिंक्डइन कैन नॉट रिसीव ईमेल्स डायरेक्टली थ्रू योर लिंक्डइन अकाउंट फ्रॉम एम्प्लॉयर्स एंड कॉन्टैक्ट्स. यू हैव टू गो अहेड एंड डू इट. LinkedIn cannot import your resume. You have to go and upload it. LinkedIn cannot build specific sections into your main profile to highlight your knowledge, experience, skills, educations. LinkedIn has no AI tool which can read the resume which you have posted there. All these updates in terms of your knowledge, in terms of your experience, in terms of your skill sets, you have to do it, you have to update it yourself. Follow industries and top resources that will affect your ability to find work. Like that, this simply means LinkedIn is just a platform which needs to be used heavily, which needs to be used rigorously. So I need to be active on that. LinkedIn will not be active for me. Okay? Ask for recommendations. Very, very important. आप जिसको भी जानते हैं, even if you are a student, you can request your professors to write some recommendation for you. You can request some of your friends. You can recommend, you can request if you know some distant relatives, right? To you know recommend you. So do this, ask for recommendations, okay? And again, if this person is known to you, you can ask them to write on a specific recommendation. Like you want your this particular skill set to be shown. So you can ask them, please write me recommendation on this particular. Like for an example, just few days back, one of the intern who was, you know, associated with my company last year, she sent me a mail. That ma'am, please send me a recommendation on the quality of work which I have done there. Okay, and my regularity. That even being an intern, I was very, very regular and punctual in terms of timing. So she was very specific about it. That please recommend me on these points. So you can also be specific to the people you are close to or whom you trust is going to do according to you. Okay, so demand recommendations, they will do it for you. Share an update with your network that is appropriate and professional. We have already spoken. Comment on others' updates when you can add value to the conversation. Agar kisi ka post aapko acha laga hai, if you have liked somebody's post, you should definitely click a like button and you should also add some comments to it. Just by liking is it not enough. Add your comments. Only add your comments if you think that this is going to add value to them. Add value to the profile, yours and the others both. Check people you may know column once a week or homepage to expand your professional network. So this is what LinkedIn does for you. वो आपके कुछ you may know लेकर आता है, right? These are the people. Recommendation is something to, you know, exaggerate your profile. Zaruri kuch nahi hai bachche life mein. Nahi, nothing is mandatory. Nothing is mandatory. This is a complete personal choice.
Thank you.
Okay. Yeah. Recommendations will definitely help you. But if you feel that there should always be genuine recommendation, that people themselves should feel that day and recommend you, there is nothing wrong in thinking like that. Fine. So, but this is a segment which is given on LinkedIn to exaggerate your profile, to showcase some of your skill sets that has been really liked by people. So it is advisable that go for it. It is just a suggestion, nothing mandate.
Okay. Thank you.
Review the jobs you may be interested in section of your homepage. Okay. So LinkedIn humse poochta hai jobs you may be interested in. Why? Because as somebody has just said that AI has become very, very significant these days. So, you know, they track your profile, what kind of roles you are looking at, what kind of jobs you are looking at, and what skill sets you have mentioned. So based on that, they also give you suggestions that these jobs you may be interested in. So go to those jobs jo LinkedIn ne aapko bheja hai. Okay. If you find it relevant, if you find it likable, apply. But always refrain from giving any kind of personal contact details. Email ID, contact number, nothing. Let them contact you through LinkedIn message box. If you are very, very sure of this application, you are very, very sure of this company and the job, then maximum that you can do is leave your email ID. Okay? But still, sending out contact numbers is not advisable. Rest, it is completely on your choice. Okay? Review the groups you may like, section of your homepage, sign up for the group that matches your professional and educational goals. So again, LinkedIn suggests you lots of job groups of a particular location, job group of particular skill sets, job group of particular work, particular company. You also follow them, right? So go and join these job groups. Find out, join it. So you keep getting updates even on those groups. So when it matches to your skill sets, your chances of getting jobs even becomes higher. Fine. Now with this, I think we come to almost we have lots of things today. Fine. Dodge the job search routine, right? Now, what is this? Some bad habits which we have, you know? So one biggest bad habit is ignoring. Even if we know this is important, we tend to ignore. We tend to procrastinate. Kal se kar lenge. Fine, let's leave it today. We'll start from tomorrow. Okay, this week, so we have Ganpati. I will start doing this after Ganpati. So all these are bad habits. Every year Ganpati will come. Every year your best friend's birthday will come. Every year lots and lots of occasions will come. But this year, if you remain jobless for a big number of time, like large number of months or weeks, or kind of this gap will become very difficult to explain to the prospective employer. So make this job search in your everyday routine without fail. Even for this, you have to leave some of your important other tasks of life. Getting the point? An overview of the bad habits that you need to change to secure a good career. So the first thing is a generic resume which you send to everybody. So during resume building, we have spoken about this. Please prepare your resume, customize your resume according to the skill sets mentioned in the job listing, in the job description. So don't be ready that I have a resume ready. Oh, this is the job. Cut, apply. done. My work is done. My work is not done. It is half done. Okay? So with every application, change, minor changes, not major, definitely. Basic cheeze nahi change ho jayenge. Aapke qualification, aapke experiences, aapke sare skill sets nahi change ho jayenge. But chote mote changes karke shayad mere chances of shortlisting badh jayenge. Theek hai? How many of you have prepared your cover letter? Please do it. Okay? Fine. So two people have raised their hands. Thanks, Gopendra, for listening to me. If you have done it because I said. So thanks a lot. And I would say that all of you, please go back and prepare a cover letter. Okay? Refuse to meet new people or attempt to network. Just now, somebody has asked me a question. Is this recommendation important? Important nahi hai bache. Lekin important hai. Sorry. Ye recommendations mere prospective employer se milne ke mere chances ko badha sakta hai. So I am not increasing my network just because I don't want to do it. It's not a right attitude. Change your attitude. If you feel, if you know I'm an introvert person, I hate to interact with people, I don't want to increase my social network, these things are not going to help you anymore. You have to come out of that zone and you have to become an extrovert. Okay? Don't refuse to meet new people. Don't refrain from talking to new people. Be social. That will make you more acceptable. Apply for everything you see, whether or not you are qualified for that job. So one another mistake that we do. Apply. Why are we supposed to do it? Read the JD properly. Leave the location which has been mentioned. Match your skill set. See the experience that it demands. You are only 5 year experience. This job is demanding 7 to 10 years experience and you have just applied for the sake of applying it. Don't do all these things and keep a track of all the companies that you have applied for. Because many a times when company calls you, right, what mistakes you do? When company calls you that we have received your application through Naukri, through LinkedIn. So you get back and ask the recruiter, for which company is this? What was the profile? Can you please tell me once again? Can you please send that JD on my email ID? So all these things creates negativity about your profile. So keep a list ready wherever you have applied for. Don't ask all these stupid questions to the recruiter. They will get just a reason to reject you because they have hundreds of applications pending to be seen. So don't go back and ask these questions to the recruiter. Keep a track. Kahan apply kiya hai? Kya JD tha? Kaun si company thi? Kya location tha? Keep everything in the mind ready or keep everything ready in the journal that we have spoken in the beginning. Continue to think that social media won't do anything for your job search. Right? Again, concentrating our mind. Isse kuch nahi hota hai. LinkedIn will never help me to get a job. I know this is all fake. Facebook is worst. It is just a waste of time. I should not do it. Instagram people only post pictures and that silly videos. There's no point for me being on social media. So ये जितने भी हमारे mental constraints हैं, ये सब हमको खुद बेवकूफ बना रहे हैं. We have to be active on this social media today. This is the demand of the hour. You have to be active. You have to make posts. You have to make comments. This doesn't mean that you start wasting your time on the social media. You have to restrict yourself. Only this much time is meant for this. Rest of the time is meant for preparations, analyzing, strategizing, planning. Okay? Post a resume on a job board and wait for the calls to start pouring in. पहले ही फॉलो अप नहीं करने लग जाएंगे, आज पोस्ट किया और कल से फॉलो अप चालू कंपनी से. विल वेट टिल द टाइम दे गिव मी अ कॉल. इफ आफ्टर अ वीक आई डोंट रिसीव अ कॉल और मे बी आफ्टर फ्यू डेज आई डोंट रिसीव अ कॉल, मे बी 4-5 days एंड आई एम वेरी मच इंटरेस्टेड, आई कैन मेक अ कॉल टू द कंपनी एंड आई ट्राई टू टॉक टू द कंसर्न पर्सन. Wing your job search and don't take the time to assess your strengths, transferable skills and ideal work environment. Job pe to apply kar diya, bas mera kaam wahan pe khatam ho gaya, maine follow up bhi kar liya. But us job mein jo maine specific skill sets apne resume mein change kiye the, usko enhance karne ke liye I have done nothing. As per the demand of the job, there were few certain things which I may don't know, but if I read or if I work on it, I can improve. But I will not do it. Who's going to waste time on this? You should refrain from doing this. Add all these things in your daily habit of job search. जैसे आप job search कर रहे हैं, वैसे ही खुद को upgrade करने के भी बारे में सोचते रहिए. ठीक है? So this is the week in review worksheet format. Again, a task for you. Weekly review sheet है जो आपको खुद भरना है अपने information के लिए, not for anybody else. What activities I have completed in this week to enhance my job search? What are the new contacts did I make this week to help me in my this job search strategy? What were the most valuable piece of information? So just a weekly worksheet. While at the time you are preparing, yeah.
इसको थोड़ा सा zoom कर सकते हो?
Okay, I'll try to do a slideshow. See if it turns. Yeah. So can you see this now?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah. So this resumes will be this PPTs will be shared. Priyanka, I really request you that please share all the PPTs to these guys so that they can take a help from it. Okay, if you don't have certain email IDs or certain contacts, please ask them to send it to you once again, okay, or mail it to you so that you can send it to them. Because unless they really go back, review and read it, there will be no use of these sessions. Trust me.
Yes, I will send all the PPTs to them, okay?
Yeah, fine.
I have a question.
Yes, please go ahead.
Being a hardcore introvert, it's very difficult based on past experience to put immediate trust on new people. So at times it becomes very tough to to make that bond with new people. So how can anyone can over that this problem?
Okay, now let's understand. What's your name?
Shubham again.
Okay, Shubham. Fine, Shubham. So I have started recognizing your voice, Shubham. You ask lots of questions. It is good. So now, Shubham, I understand. I understand this is probably because of your few past bad experiences. You have not, you are scared of making new bonds. You are scared of being more social, right? But if I ask you this question, Shubham, उन लोगों ने तो अपना काम कर दिया, आपको तकलीफ दे दिया. You know, they made you more introvert. How it has, they have impacted more on your life in a negative way, and you are also accepting it. Why? Let not these negativity impact yours or your life. Come out of this. What kind of trust are you talking? हम अब किसी को अपना बैंक अकाउंट नंबर नहीं शेयर करने वाले. हम किसी से अपना कोई पर्सनल डिटेल नहीं शेयर करने वाले हैं. We are just here to develop a conversation. When we develop conversation to new people, we learn new things. There's no point sharing in this. Don't let negativity overpower you. You overpower every negativity of your life. That is important. Come out of all these things. Being extrovert doesn't mean that we start talking to everyone that comes our way. We just, start chilling out with everyone, hanging out with everyone. That is not extrovertness. Extrovertedness means that open up with your ideas, open up with your suggestions, open up with your views, views about a small thing. This road is not good. Lots of potholes are there. Discuss about this. Open yourself. What is me kya share karna hai? What is difficult in, you know, talking about all these things? The budget was not good. This government is not working properly. This company is not, you know, giving good this benefits or rewards to the employees. What is bad in talking all these things? These are general things. We all should talk. Ye hamare baat karne ke hamare skills ko upgrade karta hai. No point putting yourself into the cocoon because a few bad people of your life. Don't let them impact you so much. Okay?
Yes.
All the best. Yes. So any more question today? So can anyone just open your videos? Yeah, tell me.
Ma'am, it's not a question. Actually, I had sent you an email. I just wanted to know whether you had received it.
Okay, what's your name?
Kiran, ma'am. Kiran.
Kiran. So I have received one email. Okay. But I didn't get time to revert. So I'm so sorry. I have received one email. I'll go back maybe maximum by this weekend. I'll revert that. Okay. If you have given your phone number, maybe I'll give you a call and talk to you also. Yeah. Don't all of you give me your phone numbers. I don't have so much of time to talk to all of you. But definitely, if you drop an email, I'll try to revert it maximum in a week or 10 days time. Okay, you can do that follow up also. That ma'am, you have not reverted on the email itself. Okay,
ma'am, more question.
Yeah.
Sometimes we feel some people or some set of people are affecting our professional life. So is it okay to marginalize ourselves? But when we speak in a professional area, it shows our personality as if we don't want to interact or some. I mean, we have some negativity in ourselves. So is it okay to marginalize us cut off from such people?
Yeah. Of course, 100%. No problem in that. There's no point getting into a toxic environment, right? There's no point, you know, showing that false mingleness or closeness. It is good that you keep yourself aside from these kind of people. If you can just do your work, you can just perform good. Your productivity is not going down. Your bosses are happy. The company is happy. That is all. Hum koi personal relationship banane nahi jaate hain organization. We all have to understand. It may happen if the other guy is also equally in connection with me, in sync with me. Okay? Otherwise, marginalization is completely acceptable. Yeah?
Yes, thank you so much.
Okay, fine. So any more questions you have?
Ma'am,
hello.
IGP fill karna hello? Better hai ya new job search karna?
Ji?
Ma'am, IGP fill karna zyada better hai ya new job search karna?
IGP fill karna?
Yes, internal job posting. What is posting.
IGP?
Internal
IGP.
Job
IGP. Posting. Yeah, IGP. IGP, yes. Of course, IGP, which the company which demands to you do that, you have to do it.
Like mere ko usse zyada better package mil raha hai achhi company mein to tab bhi mere ko matlab fill karna chahiye ab like switch karna chahiye.
See, now this is completely on your discretion. Okay, what is your demand from life? If you think that recognition and accomplishments is more important, then again it is better you remain to the same organization, because jahan par aapne itne de saal diye hai, people knows you so well, they appreciate you so much, so you know what respect milne mein nayi company mein time lag jayega. So if respect and recognition is more important, you stay back. But if growth, money, more challenges, different work environment and all these things gives you kick, you should always switch.
Okay, ma'am.
So it is completely on your discretion, your personality type, what are you expecting from life?
Got it.
Yeah, fine. So, hello, so shall we close the session? Yeah, tell me.
Hello. I want to plead with you to help us with a sample of the professional CV so we can learn how to write same too.
There is some voice in the between. Can you just repeat to yourself?
I said, can you please help us with a sample of a professional CV so we can understand how this can tailor to any organization?
No, see. In the previous session, I have mentioned few samples in the PPT. You can just go through that and you can find out. Even on internet, when you write on Google, the sample resumes, you will get lots of samples available. Even if you write sample resumes related to the skill sets that you are having, you will also get samples of the key skills that is there and the key things which is required in the resume. So you can get everything on Google. Other than that, my previous PPT contains the samples. Priyanka will send you that and you can use to refer that.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.